The University of Michigan's headline sentiment index falls to its lowest since last November, 7 months.
For author and trading mentor Simon Rhee, the signs of a looming recession in 2024 are pretty clear. Loans harder to get and more costly.
The United States, once known for its strong economy, is facing an unprecedented crisis. President Joe Biden and his administration are dealing with multiple economic problems, the most significant of which is that American consumers are running out of money. This worrying situation has far-reaching consequences, threatening the nation's economy and pushing it toward collapse. Such an economic downturn will be devastating, affecting every sector and the lives of millions of Americans. The United States is on the brink of an economic crisis, with many Americans struggling to make ends meet. President Joe Biden's administration is under increasing pressure as consumer confidence drops and spending power dwindles. The signs of an impending recession are clear, and the economic downturn could have significant implications for the upcoming presidential election. Consumer confidence is a critical indicator of economic health, reflecting how optimistic or pessimistic consumers are about their financial situation and the economy as a whole. The University of Michigan's Consumer Sentiment Index recently revealed a sharp decline, dropping to a 7-month low of 65.6 in June. This drop in confidence suggests that consumers are increasingly worried about their financial future. The decline can be attributed to several factors, with rising inflation being the primary concern. Consumers are anticipating a 3.3% increase in prices over the next year. This expectation is slightly higher than the 3.1% anticipated for the next 5 to 10 years. The perception that wages are not keeping pace with inflation worsens the problem. Consumers feel their spending power has significantly diminished, leading to a more pessimistic view of the economy. Inflation has been a persistent issue, affecting everything from groceries to gas prices. The cost of living has increased, but wages have not kept up, leaving many Americans struggling to maintain their standard of living. The surge in gas prices, in particular, has been a visible indicator of inflation for most consumers. As they see their fuel costs rise, their concerns about broader economic inflation grow. This mismatch between wage growth and inflation has led to a decline in disposable income. When consumers feel financially squeezed, they cut back on spending, further slowing economic growth. Since consumer spending accounts for about 70% of the U.S. economy, any significant reduction in spending can have severe repercussions. Retail sales data from major corporations like McDonald's, Burger King, Walmart, and Target have shown that consumers are indeed running out of money. The reduction in discretionary spending is evident, as these companies report lower sales and profits. This trend is worrying because it suggests that consumers are prioritizing essential goods and services over non-essential items, indicating financial strain. Additionally, a gauge of consumers' current assessments of their personal finances has slid to its lowest level since October, indicating that many Americans are not confident about their financial stability. This lack of confidence can lead to reduced spending, which in turn can trigger a recession. The economic challenges facing the U.S. pose a significant threat to President Biden's chances of re-election. Historically, voters tend to make their decisions based on their financial situation, often referred to as voting with their pocketbooks. If the economy continues to decline, Biden's support base could reduce. The timing of the economic downturn is also critical. With the presidential election approaching, any prolonged economic hardship could severely impact Biden's campaign. Voters typically form their opinions about the economy and the incumbent administration several months before the election. If the economy is in recession by then, it could be detrimental to Biden's re-election prospects. Another troubling sign is the softening labor market. The unemployment rate recently rose to 4%, the highest in over 2 years. Although the Federal Reserve projects that this may be the peak, there are concerns that it could go higher. Rising unemployment can further dampen consumer confidence and spending, creating a vicious cycle that worsens the economic downturn. Continued unemployment claims have also increased, reaching over 1.8 million. This rise in claims indicates that more people are struggling to find work, which can lead to long-term financial instability for many families. The relationship between consumer confidence and unemployment is well documented. Confidence tends to drop further as more people remain unemployed. Many Americans took on significant debt during the past few years to cope with rising living costs and economic uncertainty. Buy now, pay later loans surged, providing temporary relief, but leading to long-term financial burdens. With higher interest rates, the cost of servicing this debt has increased, adding to the financial pressure on consumers. Higher gas prices have also tipped consumers over the edge. As the cost of essential goods and services rises, disposable income shrinks, forcing many to cut back on spending. This reduction in consumer spending can slow economic growth, further deepening the recession. The middle class, historically seen as the backbone of the U.S. economy, is feeling the pinch. Their financial views now resemble those of lower-income consumers, a departure from historical patterns. This squeeze on the middle class suggests that they are not confident about their ability to get ahead financially. As a result, they are likely to reduce spending and increase savings, which can further slow economic growth. Gas prices have been a significant factor in consumer spending patterns. Rising prices at the pump affect consumers directly and have broader economic implications. Higher transportation costs can increase prices for goods and services, adding to the inflationary pressures. President Biden's attempts to lower gas prices have included measures like releasing oil from the Strategic Petroleum Reserve. However, these efforts have had limited success, and OPEC's actions to keep prices high have further complicated the situation. If gas prices continue to rise, it could lead to a more pronounced economic downturn. The slide in consumer sentiment and the various economic indicators point towards a restrained consumer demand in the coming months. The University of Michigan's measure of buying conditions for durable goods has decreased to its lowest level since December. When consumers cut back on purchasing durable goods, it signals reduced confidence in the economy's future. This reduction in demand can lead to inventory buildups, lower new orders for factories, and job cuts. As businesses adjust to lower demand, the economic impact can ripple through various sectors, leading to further declines in economic activity. The economic challenges faced by U.S. consumers are not isolated, but are part of a broader global economic context. Many other countries are experiencing similar issues, with rising debt levels, inflation, and declining consumer confidence. For instance, in Germany, households are increasingly buckling under debt after a few rocky years for the economy. The erosion of purchasing power by inflation and high interest rates is leaving a growing number of households overburdened, mirroring the situation in the U.S. The Federal Reserve plays a crucial role in managing the U.S. economy, primarily through controlling interest rates. In response to high inflation, the Fed has raised interest rates, which has helped to slow down inflation to some extent. However, these higher interest rates have also made borrowing more expensive, impacting consumer and business spending. The Federal Reserve is trying to balance controlling inflation and avoiding a recession. Even with some signs of improvement in inflation, the Fed is being careful about lowering rates too soon. They want to make sure that inflation is fully under control. The road ahead is filled with challenges, and addressing consumers' economic issues requires a multifaceted approach. This includes policies to boost wage growth, control inflation, and support those most affected by economic hardships. Additionally, it is crucial to implement measures to manage consumer debt and promote financial stability. The economic situation in the U.S. is complex and interconnected with global economic trends. The financial strain on consumers is not solely a result of recent events, but rather a culmination of various factors that have been building over time. Addressing these issues requires a comprehensive understanding of the underlying causes and a coordinated effort to implement effective solutions. One of the administration's most pressing priorities should be restoring consumer confidence and reviving spending power. This could involve multiple approaches, like combining targeted fiscal policies, tax incentives, and initiatives aimed at boosting disposable income for middle-class and low-income households. By implementing temporary tax relief, enhanced child tax credits, or direct stimulus payments, the administration could provide much-needed financial support to struggling families, enabling them to meet their basic needs and inject fresh capital into the consumer economy. Alongside efforts to bolster consumer spending, the Biden administration must prioritize the preservation and growth of small businesses, which are the lifeblood of the American economy. This could involve expanding loan programs, tax incentives for hiring and investment, and targeted relief measures for industries hit hardest by the economic downturn. Additionally, the administration could explore public-private partnerships and innovative financing mechanisms to encourage entrepreneurship and the creation of new businesses. By nurturing a vibrant small business ecosystem, the government can foster job creation, drive innovation, and lay the foundation for long-term economic prosperity. While immediate measures are crucial to address the current crisis, the Biden administration must also tackle the underlying structural challenges that have contributed to the erosion of consumer confidence and spending power. This could involve initiatives to address wage stagnation, promote workforce development and upskilling, and invest in critical infrastructure to support economic competitiveness. Moreover, the administration should prioritize the transition towards a more sustainable and equitable economic model that balances economic growth with environmental sustainability and social justice. By embracing clean energy technologies, promoting green jobs, and addressing issues such as income inequality and access to affordable housing, the government can lay the groundwork for a more resilient and inclusive economy. To navigate this economic crisis, President Biden must collaborate with members of Congress from both parties. By fostering open dialogue and seeking common ground on critical policy measures, bipartisan consensus can be built to ensure the longevity and effectiveness of economic recovery efforts. Furthermore, the administration should prioritize international cooperation and diplomacy, recognizing the interconnected nature of the global economy. Working with allies and partners, the United States can leverage collective resources, share best practices, and develop coordinated strategies to promote global economic stability and growth. The United States is facing an unparalleled economic crisis, with consumers running out of money and spending power evaporating. President Joe Biden's administration must address declining consumer confidence, bolster spending power, support small businesses and job creation, and foster bipartisan consensus. This requires bold leadership, innovative solutions, and a shift towards a more sustainable and equitable economic model.